Common data elements, part 2 of 4. Again, my name is John Walter McKeeby. I'm the Chief Information Officer at the Clinical Center of the NIH. And we utilize common data elements to share data across clinical research. So this is the second part of the series. So we're going to review NIH data management and sharing policy. Under the data management sharing policy, NIH expects that investigators and institutes plan and budget for the management and sharing of data. All researchers need to submit a data management sharing plan for review when applying for funding, comply with the approved data management sharing plan. Individual NIH institutes, centers, and offices may have additional policies and expectations, and we identify a link for those policies. CDEs can be a part of a compliant data management and sharing plan. They should be. They allow the sharing to occur. Using common data elements can be part of an effective plan for managing and sharing data. According to the policy, NIH encourages researchers to use common data elements in order to improve accuracy, consistency, and interoperability among data sets within various areas of health and disease research. We provided links here on Office of Intramural Research Guidance, as well as Office of Intramural Research Intramural Data Management and Sharing Plan Templates. They state that researchers must describe what common data elements will be used in their project and to justify if common data elements will not be used. Common data element usage at NIH. Some institutes and centers have had mature common data element programs for years. Examples are the Clinical Center Beatrice, which is the repository for the intramural program at the NIH of all the clinical research data. And then NINDS has common data elements across domains of different diseases, and we'll talk about that. NLM has been involved with common data elements since 2012. NLM encourages the adoption of common data elements across NIH. There's an NIH Common Data Element Task Force, and there's an NIH Common Data Elements Repository. And we'll review all these items in the next set of slides. So Beatrice is the NIH Intramural Research Program Research Clinical Data Warehouse. We've had data since 1976 in different databases, different systems, in our original EHR, which was referred to as MIS, our original laboratory system. And so we have all this data and we want to utilize it. So we developed a terminology to allow this. So the Beatrice common data element is referred to as RED, the Research Entity Dictionary. Beatrice allows bi-directional exchange of data between clinical and IC research systems. Medical record number is the key identifier to identify a patient. We have self-service as well as assisted data curation, and we facilitate data exchange with research collaborators. We provide data from Beatrice to multiple clinical systems, utilizing the common data elements that are specific to our research entities dictionary. And so Beatrice, we have multiple systems that feed our data repository referred to as Beatrice. We provide the data through extractions, our self-service, as well as we produce reports specific to request. And so this is the services that Beatrice provides. Beatrice is based on the Research Entities Dictionary, referred to as RED. It allows interoperability across NIH IC systems, allows multiple classifications and hierarchies to coexist, and it allows tests to be defined across years, names, type of test, And so a glucose ordered and missed, if it's following the same reference range, following the same instruments, glucose and CRIS, which is our current EHR, various types of ordering the glucose would be all identified as the same test. Below is the red web search. So you can search for specific items and know the values. And by clicking it, then you can find values across the entire repository that fit that item. So this is an example of common data elements specific for NIH intramural program.